Wouldn't it be cool if you could change this Java code, which uses string concatenation, with something more readable like this? This is a feature called string templates, which were added as a preview feature in Java 21 and are in their second preview feature in Java 22. Here's how they work. This right here is a string template. It's got two pieces to it. The first piece over here is what's called the template processor, and the piece over here is called the template argument, or just the template. What this particular template processor is responsible for is what's called string interpolation, which is something that other languages support, such as Kotlin, Groovy, Python, JavaScript, etc. For those of you familiar with some of those languages, the syntax is a little more familiar. Basically, what you do is you can put a variable embedded within a string, and then it gets put into there for you. The only real difference is that you have the template processor here at the beginning, and then you have these delimiters, which are going to be the backslash and then curly braces, rather than something like a dollar sign like you might see in other languages. But don't be fooled. This feature is a lot more powerful than basic string interpolation. In my opinion, the Java designers did something right here, and what they're doing is they're making a much more secure and powerful feature beyond just adding syntactic sugar. So now I want to get into two reasons why you should be using string templates right now if you aren't already using them. The first one is going to get into readability of your code, and the second one is going to get into more of the true power behind these new template expressions that are being proposed as part of this string templates feature. Let's get into it. So the first reason that you should be using string templates right now is because of the readability impacts of your code. It doesn't really matter if you can write good code if no one can read it and maintain it. Let's go with an example. Let's make a name variable. We'll call this person John Smith. And we'll say that John is 30. And then now we want to make a message. And then we're going to say, hi, my name is... And then we have to concatenate the name field, and I am age years old. And we won't even mention the fact that I really should probably have a ternary expression here to say if I am 1 year old, I should say 1 year old rather than 1 year old. But we're just going to leave that as is. This works, and this is what we're used to as Java developers, but it's kind of messy. If I don't want to do that, I can have some other alternatives. So let's say that I want to use the formatted method. I can go in here, and instead of having them in line, I can add format specifiers like this. And then I can say name age. And this works as well, and you would get the same output. The difference here, though, is that you're still not having a really straightforward way of saying what this %s and %d are unless you know to look at the end. When you're only talking about two variables, yeah, maybe it's not that big of a deal. But let's say you're trying to build something a little more complicated, like a string of 5 or 6 or 7 things all concatenated together. Yeah, that gets kind of annoying and cumbersome to say, okay, this is the fourth parameter, therefore it's the fourth one in the list kind of thing. But Will, why can't you just use string builder or string buffer for that? Yeah, you could, but that's just gonna have a whole bunch of append methods. And that's what the string builder variant looks like. And yeah, this works, but this is a lot of characters just to do some basic string interpolation. So here come in string templates. Instead of wanting to use these methods, I'm going to use something a little more straightforward. So we will say, str dot, which str is that template processor, which automatically gets imported into every Java file. And then now I'm going to have a template argument, or a template, which contains embedded expressions that are delimited like this. And in this case, my embedded expression is just going to be a variable. It's going to be called name. And now I don't need to declare this here. And then likewise, I can just do that. And then if we print it out, we can see that it works just how we would expect it to. One thing you'll notice within the compilation instructions here is that I do have enable preview on. You do need to do that as of Java 22 because this is still only in its second preview, and I sure hope that it gets added into the language later. I don't know about you, but I think that this line of code is a good bit more readable compared to the previous versions. You can see very clearly that you are embedding the name an age locals within this string, and it's going to all get converted into that singular string that then gets printed. I think that that's pretty straightforward to read. But if you're not convinced, stick with me here. There's a lot more that I can do than just printing out values in here. I can actually do arithmetic. So let's say that instead of being 30, I want to add 1 to their age. Now we can see that we're 31 here. Or what we can do is we can even call some methods. Let's say something like this. So now I want to get the length of the string associated with John Smith. And I probably should have changed a string around here, but it's inserting 10, which is the string length of the name local here. So what we can see here is that we can put in most any expression within something like this. One restriction is that you can't have multiple lines of code within a single one of these embedded expressions. Think of it as a single line lambda where you have quite a bit of flexibility, but you can't do everything that you would want within it. If you wanted to, you could even add some extra spaces here, and this won't affect the string in the end. And one other thing that's important to note is that all of this is evaluated at runtime when you're actually executing this particular line of code. So to demonstrate that, let's say age++, and then we want to print out age at the bottom. We can see here that the value of age starts at 30 when we're printing it this first time, and then the post increment operator is going to increment it after we've executed it. So now it is going to be 31 by the time that we are executing this embedded expression. And then we do another post increment, and then we print out the final value of 32. So this is runtime evaluated, meaning that if you want to get the current state of something within a method or a variable or things like that, you can do that with these embedded expressions here with string templates. Another thing you could do if you really wanted to is you can embed a string template within a string template. So let's say I want to do this, and then I'm going to go ahead and add the name here. So I start with my name is, and then I get into my embedded expression within my embedded expression. So these can be nested, they can include arithmetic, they can include method calls, and one other thing I haven't touched on yet is they can also include something like a ternary operator. Another place where I think a string template really shines is with a text block. So let's go ahead and look at that. Something like this. Now let's say I want to write some JSON. I could say name, and then I can just embed it like this. And then I can say the age is age. And of course, I do have to add the template processor like that, because otherwise we would need to use something like formatted, which again would work, but it's not as easy to read when you start having a really complicated, either one-liner or text block string. Something that would be filling out a whole bunch of HTML or some JSON or SQL or something like that. We can see here when we print this out, we do get valid JSON here, except that I don't really like how that formatted, so I'm going to do that. Code readability is a really important thing to get right. And if you ask me, this is kind of a no-brainer. If I can do basic string interpolation with a template processor that the JDK already provides for me, why wouldn't I do that? And if you are looking at these four characters here at the beginning, wondering why do I have to include these to indicate a string template? Well, that's to really make sure that as a developer, you're doing your job and you're indicating to Java that you want to make a string template and that you're not including like an embedded expression in something that's not intended to be a template. That was a conscious decision that was made when this preview feature was turned on. If you ask me, I think that 4 characters is a small price to pay, and I think that it's totally fine there. It makes it clear to me up front that I'm looking at a template rather than just a regular string. The second reason you should be using this feature right now is due to how powerful it can be. You could do a lot more than basic string interpolation, and that is based on the processor that you are giving it. So the first 3 characters here within this template expression are the template processor. A template processor is nothing more than an instance of a particular class within the JDK. So let's take a look at the documentation here. STR is a public static final string template.processor that is parameterized as string and runtime exception. Okay, so what does that mean? So the first thing is that string template.processor is a functional interface that has the process method which is responsible for doing the actual processing of the template with the template processor. And then these two parameters indicate different things that the template's going to do. This first parameter indicates the output of the template. So I'm going to return a string when I'm done with my string template. And then this parameter refers to the types of exceptions that I might throw. So in this case, I don't have any checked exceptions that string interpolation could throw, so it's parameterized as throwing runtime exception. But the cool thing here to think about is that the processors can return more than just strings. They can return basically anything that would be a Java object. But let's go into some of the other built-in processors that the JDK provides for us. So str, or string, is one of them, which provides basic string interpolation. Another one is raw, which you'll notice we do have to import, which is a little bit different than string. But what raw does is raw returns a string template, as you can see right here. So while str returned an interpolated string, raw returns the string template again. So how I would use that is if I just print out message, we'll see that that's not really what we expect. What we're doing is we're calling toString on string template, which contains a fragments, which is an array of the different elements within the string template. And then we have the values that we're going to substitute it with. So this is giving you a bit of an inside peek into how string templates are implemented. You have these fragments and you have these values, which together come into the final result that the template expression is going to evaluate to. So how do I get the end string that I want to when I am using the raw template processor? Well, it's actually pretty easy. I'm going to say final message equals str.process message. Now I want to say final message, and we get back to the original value we wanted. So basically, str.process is doing the same type of thing that it was doing, except instead of giving it the raw template argument like we did previously, we're now giving it a string template. So this process method is the method that is getting called when a string template gets acted upon. Basically, when we have the syntax template processor, template argument, or also called template, what's happening is the template argument is getting converted into a string template object under the hood, and then it gets passed in as a parameter to the process method of the template processor. So in this case, it would go to the implementation of the process method for the str template processor. We can see here that it takes in the string template as an argument, and then what it's doing is it's taking the fragments and it's taking the values from the string templates, and then it's going to run a formatter over that string. Quick aside, the implementation speed of a string template is actually pretty good. Regular string concatenation within Java is typically converted into string builder appends by the Java compiler. So if you were to look at the bytecode, typically that's how it's implemented. However, when you use string.format or string formatted, oftentimes you get a pretty good performance degradation because there has to be a lot of processing of the format string to make sure that you can convert it back into the string you want to in the end. You would think that a string template might have the similar overhead of formatted, but it actually really doesn't. I haven't profiled this to really get into the nitty-gritty of the performance differences, but my initial take on this is that string templates have comparable performance to something like concatenation. I don't know if I'd call it exactly the same. In fact, it's probably never going to be as good as concatenation, but in my experience at least, it's much better than formatted strings. So take everything there with a grain of salt, because performance is a bit of a tough nut to crack. Let me know in the comments if you end up doing any performance characterizations of this. I'd be kind of curious to hear about that. So where this concept of custom template processors really starts to shine is all the implications that can come from that. For example, let's say that you want to have an SQL statement and you want to write to a database. Previously, what you'd have to do is you would need to look at the input parameters that you might put into your string before you make a query result. You'd have to sanitize them to make sure you don't have something like an injection attack. However, with something like a string template, basically what you can do is you can make your own custom template, and in the process method, you can do some validation of the SQL query to make sure that you aren't going to be susceptible to injection attacks. And then instead of returning the string at the end, just like as a basic interpolated string, you can actually return the prepared statement that you can then execute on the database. Pretty nifty, huh? If you want to learn more, I'd highly recommend you check out JEP 459, which is the JDK enhancement proposal responsible for string templates in their second preview as of JDK 22. This JEP goes into quite a bit of detail as far as the motivation, the details, everything you'd really want to know about the string template feature. And it goes in to say here about how interpolation is very dangerous, which I agree with. So please, please do not just use string templates as a syntactic sugar for interpolation, because that's only scratching the surface of what this feature can actually do. I would highly recommend you really dig in and figure out how to make your own template processors. And then that process method can be highly specific to a particular need, and it can do the validation of the data, and you can streamline it in a way to make your code also more readable at the same time. For those curious, here in the JEP, it does spell out an example implementation for that SQL processor. So it's making a query builder record, which passes in the connection object, and then it's implementing the string template processor, where it is returning a prepared statement. And it can also now throw a checked exception, which is that SQL exception here. So it takes in the string template as the argument into the process method, like we were looking at earlier for the str template processor. And then what it's going to do is it's going to have all of the fragments assembled into the query. And then at the bottom, it's going to put all of those fragments back in and their associated values. This prevents something like an injection attack where you're adding in additional filter criteria or widening the filter criteria that you would select instead of just providing a value for like a name or something like that. All in all, a really cool feature. This is something that I think as the Java community, we should be embracing, and we should take it upon ourselves to start adding this into our code because it's going to be more readable, it's going to be more secure, and it's going to be more customizable. This whole concept of template expressions is pretty nifty. And that was an overview of the string templates feature. What do you think about string templates and template expressions? Is this something that you think you're going to use? Leave a comment and let me know. If you enjoyed this video or if you learned something new, please do smash that like button. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a good rest of your day, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.